Kamala Entertainment TV. Today is the 8th of April at 2023. So the Constitutional Court has agreed to urgently hear opposition MTC leader Senator Douglas Monzora's application, which challenges the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission ZEC delimitation report. Monzora filed a chamber application for direct access to the apex court, which was granted because his case was considered arguable. A bench led by Paddington Garwe ruled that Senator Douglas Monzora's delimitation challenge is valid and must be heard by a full bench. Monzora wants the ZEC delimitation report to be nullified, claiming that it was not done properly. ZEC argues that everything is in order and that redoing the report would be a waste of resources. Trust Manda, representing Monzora, said that the senator had an equal interest in the matter since he's running in the upcoming elections. He argued that Monzora's case should be heard as it involves the abuse of constitutional rights and that ZEC relied on a preliminary census report by Zimstat, which was wrong. Manda said the contention before the court is that the delimitation report is an essential element of achieving free and fair elections. The position of the appellant is that unless the delimitation report is in terms of the constitution, it is unconstitutional. Tawanda Kanongoni, speaking on behalf of ZEC, argued that there was little difference between the preliminary and final census report from Zimstat and that Monzora's case had no basis. Kanongoni also said that Monzora's application lacked clarity because it did not specify what he found discriminatory. Award-winning journalist Hopewell claimed that the ruling party ZANU-PF doesn't want elections scheduled for later this year to proceed. Is using Monzora, it's alleged early, to push that agenda through courts. Elections could be delayed if Monzora wins the case, as the delimitation exercise would need to be redone. Zimbabwe is set to hold harmonized elections between July 26 and August 26 of this year. And so that's the latest here. But I don't understand. Hopewell is the same guy who was criticizing the same report. I still remember him saying that some of the coordinates are removed. Delimitation report, Akuto Tawara Jumbo, Ziriku Mozambique, Ziriku Madagascar, and stuff like that. But he's again saying the other side. I mean, personally, it doesn't make sense. Quantity doesn't really make sense because Hope was the person who was criticizing this whole process. Even Wachamisa at a press conference a few weeks ago, he was also criticizing the voters' roll and the same report which Wamunzora lodged in parliament. That's why I was saying on my last video that Wamunzora had something here that he needs support from the other opposition political parties. And yes, this report needs to be redone again. So guys, I got it all in the comment section. This is a weekend news roundup on Prince Mela Entertainment TV. I really don't understand our opposition political parties. What's their game plan? Because as far as I'm really concerned here, this report is very crucial for my elections this year. Voters' role is very crucial for my elections this year. So kana vasingasumudze musoro vasingataure nyaya idzi vozodzidzwa maelections anga siri free and fair, because munenge maluza maelections aya. Munova kuti anzi ZANU-PF yakariga maelections, but when it's time for you guys to raise my big points, my big crucial points, hamusumudze musoro, munenge makanyarara, munenge muri zii. So keeping you guys up to date with the latest here on our weekend news roundup on Prince Mela Entertainment.